Today, we will discuss groundwater. We've already discussed the hydrologic cycle, and groundwater is a very important part of that hydrologic cycle. But why is groundwater important? Well, there are several reasons. One, we are depleting our supplies of groundwater, principally for irrigation. That's a major issue. Contamination is another problem. We sometimes contaminate groundwater. You can't drink contaminated groundwater. We also have an issue with radioactive waste. Where are we going to put all of our radioactive waste? Other reasons groundwater is important in terms of geothermal energy. Groundwater can produce ore deposits, and it can also cause caves to form, which we'll talk about a little later in this video. Now, when water occurs in the ground, there are two zones. There's the VADOSE zone, which is above what is called the water table, and then there's the phreatic zone, which is below the water table. The VADOSE zone, the pores are filled mostly with air, maybe a little bit of water. In the phreatic zone, below the water table, the pores are filled with water. And there are a couple terms we need to review when we think about groundwater. One of those terms is porosity. What is the porosity? It's the volume of pore space in the rock. Another term is permeability, which is the ease of flow through rocks. Porosity and permeability are often related. For example, if the porosity is connected, you will probably have good permeability. Now, underground, if we have a rock that has a lot of water, we call it an aquifer. That's a highly permeable or porous zone that can hold water. It's commonly associated with shales, which are impermeable and are called aquitards, either above the aquifer or below it. And these are a very important water source in many parts of the country. We need to be concerned about depletion and contamination of our groundwater supplies. And we also have to be a bit concerned, depending on where you are, about caves and sinkholes. So what are caves and where do they form? Well, most caves form at the top of the water table if they form in a limestone terrain. Remember, water is a weak acid and it accumulates at the top of the water table. And it can dissolve limestones and that can create a cave. Now let's assume a cave forms, all right, and there's been some erosion on the land surface. And let's say a cow walks on top of that cave. What can happen? The cow can fall in and the whole cave can collapse into itself, and that is called a sinkhole. Sinkholes are very common in limestone terrains. Almost every year you will hear about a city or a house in Florida where they've had a sinkhole and somebody's lost a house or lost a car. It is a big problem wherever you have limestone terrains as the bedrock.